So there's certain things that will stimulate the release of cortisol. That is an emotional experience. So some people who have low cortisol, they'll tend to try and get into fights, literally emotional fights, and trigger you to draw into a fight because that will release their cortisol and they'll feel better when their cortisol is released. Or they tend to have addictive natures. These are the people with low adrenal function, inability to produce enough cortisol specifically, and they'll have like a drama queen or a drama king, right? They'll create drama, as I mentioned, but they'll also crave sugars and salts and spicy food. They almost to the excess, and even alcohol consumption triggers temporarily the release of cortisol and they feel better for a while. Or they'll seek certain stimulant medications and drugs. So you really have to, if that's you that I'm talking about, I know I tended to have a very low cortisol levels as measured by 24 urine and saliva. That's where you pick it up easiest. In blood, you don't quite measure because it has to stay in a fairly narrow range within the blood. So I recommend at some point that you get these special saliva cortisol test. You just spit into the tube in the morning, at night. If you have more concern about a heavy duty type of fatigue, then you spit in the tubes four times, morning, midday, afternoon, and evening.